friends, when we are searching some information over the internet, then basically the thing provided by we people, it is domain name. We simply provide the domain name and how information is being searched. Nowhere we have moved into the detail how we are getting information, where it is located, etc. There is one term which generally we know, but generally we do not use it. It is called IP address. IP address is an internet protocol address. It is a numeric label assigned to each device, that can be computer, printer or any resource, that means information can also be participating in computer network that uses the internet protocol for communication. There are two formats available for IP address. These are IPv4, that is of the 32-bit, and IPv4 basically is being used in most of the cases. Second one is IPv6, it is of the 64-bit. Generally, we least use it, but recently it even has been launched and being used successfully by the candidates. Here is an example of IPv4 format. IPv4 format contains total 32-bit. There are 4 segments, each segment of 8-bit. Each 8-bit can have numeric value from 0 to 255, that means total 256 different values. So, here is an IP address which contains 172.16.254.1. That means there are 4 different segments uniquely combined to find any particular resource over the internet. Friends, when we are providing domain name from our own side, then there is a system called domain name system which converts this domain name into corresponding IP address. Therefore, there is no necessity of remembering this kind of numeric value by we people. It is the botheration of domain name system. Here is a format in which the internet provides information to the next receiver from transmitter. There are various segments. It contains version, IHL, type of service, total length, identification, flags, fragment offset, time to leave, protocol, header checksum, source address, destination address, option which are padding in the earlier part, and data available. Description of all these different segments are as version. It indicates the version of IP address currently being used. That means whether we are using IPv4 or VP6. IP header length. It indicates the datagram header length in 32-bit words. Type of service used to control identification of various fragments. Total length, it specifies the length of entire packet in bytes including header and data. Means basically this IP address consists of these 32 bits and one data segment is padded with it. So, total length is being available in total length segment. Identification is a number assigned to current datagram so that we can say that this datagram is from this source. Flags, this is a specific 3-bit figure which is used for handling the type of datagram being transmitted. Fragment offset, suppose one datagram is of larger length, then it is divided into certain fragments, may contain 4 segments, may contain 5 segments. So, this particular segment contains which number, it is available in fragment offset. It indicates the position of the fragment's data relative to beginning of the data in original datagram. Time to leave, it maintains a counter gradually decrements down to 0 at which the datagram is discarded. Means friends, the datagram once transmitted will be retained up to some limit. After that particular limit, that will be removed from source. Protocol, it indicates which layer protocol receives upcoming packet after IP processing is complete. Header checksum, suppose the IP header what we have provided is in the proper format or not, whether it is containing proper bits or not. So, this is being handled by this header checksum. So, it helps ensuring IP header integrity. Source address, that means who has transmitted the information. So, source address specifies the IP address of the sending node. Destination address specifies the receiving node. Options allow IP to support various options as far as security is concerned. Data contains upper layer information. So, it were some different segments which are supposed to be used by IP address. Now friends, question arises, what is basic function of IP? So, the one important function of IP is what? Fragmentation and reassembly of packet. That means, suppose source wants to transmit large amount of data. So, this data is converted into datagram. If datagram is of large size, then this datagram is further converted into fragments. So, from source, these fragments are transmitted. Each fragment is having unique number. At the receiver, naturally what is being received? Fragments only. These fragments are reassembled at receiver. It helps to maximum packet size allowed by network. So, friends, fragmentation will allow maximum capacity of network being used. Routing uses the IP addresses. Routing is a process which is used by IP address simply just to ensure which is the optimum path as far as our entire transmission is being concerned. Header error detection. Suppose the information which I want to transmit, IP address of this information contains some error. This is also a botheration of IP address process mechanism to ensure that there is any error or not. Identification of higher level protocol. Next protocol will be what? It is again identification by the IP address. IP is a datagram service which provides a unreliable connectionless datagram service. Means friends, when transmission takes place, there is no any dedicated connection between transmitter and receiver. So, transmitter transmit the information wherever the path available, it will be going to be moved across it and finally delivered to destination. IP packets contain the source and destination address so that the receiver can know from where the packet has been received, and transmitter even can say to whom the data packet is being delivered. IP spoofing attack. Friends, sometimes hacker basically does what? They are trying to change the source ID in the IP address. So, receiver when receives the information is not in a position to see whether it is the proper transmitter or not. So, it retransmit some information to the sender, that is the source one, to ensure whether the source is proper one or not. IP routes individual IP datagram forwarded from router to router in between the path, as it is connection less or transmission. So, there is not any dedicated path. So, if datagram is transmitted from one end, then in what way it is moving, hardly it matters. IP is never used directly by the application. Instead, application use domain name and DNS converts this domain name into IP address using the resolver. Now friends, there is some mechanism as far as our IP addressing is concerned. So, an IP address is a logical identifier for a computer or device on the network. The key feature of IP address is that they can route across the network. Means, nowhere we need to see whether the path is available or not. Only the botheration what we should have, that means simply transmit the packet wherever the path is available, it will be going to move across it. Yes, IP address is a 32-bit numeric address written as 4 numbers separated by periods. Each segment of the IP address may range from 0 to 255, for example, 2.165.12.230 would be a valid IP as it contains all the value within the range of 0 to 255. The 4 numbers in an IP address are used to identify a particular network and host within that network. So, each host is assigned unique number. So, friends, IP address basically is divided into broadly 3 different classes, each class having its own segment. These class are called class A, class B, class C. As you can notice, this is entire address of 32 bit. 0 bit, that is the first bit, is permanently 0, and 1 to 7 for network address, 6 to 31 for host address. In class B, first 2 bits are fixed, that is 10, 2 to 15 for network address and 16 to 31 for host address. In class C, 3 bits are fixed, that is 110, 3 to 23rd bit are basically used for network and 24 to 31 for host number. What is the purpose of dividing different bits in this way? Here, the network number identifies the network and host number identifies the host. Class A address supports 16 million hosts on each of 126 network. Means we can have different 126 network in which this IP address can move, and 16 million hosts even can be connected to such sort of address. Means when we are having a large network, then we rather should use class A address. Class B address supports 65,000 hosts on each of 16,000 networks. So friends, in this particular case, so number of network have been increased and number of hosts have been reduced. This is at the middle position. So it is used for middle level network. That means neither we are having large number of hosts nor we are having large number of networks. Class C address supports 254 hosts on each of 2 million hosts only. Used for small network, means when we are going to have message to be transmitted among small network, then rather we should use class C address. Now friends, I will discuss various applications of internet. Though internet even can be used in series of so many classifications, but here my main orientation will be towards either business organizations or educational institutes or various services which are rendered by internet. We will be going to call them as governance or e-governance. So now first we will discuss some business activities where internet is very much helpful. So first category among this business activities are corporate activities. That means various activities which are run by various organizations. So organizations even can use internet in gathering corporate intelligence. Means suppose if I want to know my product is supposed to be liked by people or not, so I even can search identical product over the net. Net will be going to provide me certain information. Using it, I even can judge whether my product will be feasible to various users or not. Another, enhancing corporate communications. That means one organization even can have very good communication among various its client, vendors, etc. Improving public relations. Friends, by quick response using the facilities of mail or something else, the internet even can help corporate to have users, that is client, satisfied. Providing new ways to recruit employees. If I want to give any ad in the advertisement over the physical media, that is paper media, so may it be tough for me to invest to use amount. If I am putting my recruitment over the internet, then naturally I even can invite people from entire universe. Friends, another activity used by corporate organizations are developing electronic publishing and new information services. That means if a organization wants to launch its services, product, then it can launch it using internet. Achieving cost saving and efficiency, means using internet, if any kind of communication is there, publicity is there, friends, it hardly matters as far as cost is concerned. Now, using internet, we can acquire market intelligence also, monitoring customer discussion and attitudes, what the customer requires, what is the nature of the customers. Monitoring customer developed website, if various websites are there, we even can watch what are their requirements even. Monitoring competitor activities, if identical organization is going to have some sort of same activities, then by viewing their own website, we even can compare where we exist, conducting market research. Another activity as far as corporate sectors is concerned, it is selling. It is electronic stores or mall. Friends, I hope all of we might be using sale from internet. That means putting order over internet, getting material directly delivered to our home and making payment when material is being delivered. Order taking and providing information over status, distribution of digital data. Now, another segment as such is concerned, this is education. Education as such is concerned, friend, there is tremendous variation in educational segment, as you might be going to read all these information using internet. This is what one of the very good facility provided by internet. So, internet provides knowledge and information on every aspect of the educational world. Friends, whatever topic you want, you even can acquire information using internet. Internet also provides the opportunity to study online. Means, nowhere friends now for a specific segment, I need to join any particular organization, any particular institution physically. Suppose, if there is an organization which is in another city where I can't go, I can do one thing, I even can have some online study material regarding that particular segment which I require, and I can join online courses also. The virtual university, that means those university which are not calling their students physically. So, these are called virtual universities. Virtual universities setup allows students to go for online courses without physically going to the university. And friends, after completion of the course, examination definitely will be there, and after successful completion of the examination, respective certificate even can be handed over to we people by mail or physical mail. So, only sitting at home without contributing much more time, we can get knowledge regarding that course, we can get degree regarding that course, like that. Research is one another application used by user as far as our education is concerned. Many of the person who are involved in research application are searching information, various area where research even can be made, various area which require some sort of research, etc. Some sort of such information even can be acquired using internet. Now, friends, when we are getting some sort of such tremendous facilities, naturally these facilities comes under governance. Now, in my discussion, I will be going to discuss only those activities which are neither part of education nor part of business. Any other activities which are used by we people during our homely environment, during our domestic environment, during government organization communication, etc. So, as far as governance is concerned, there is availability of various formats of performa on e-portal. Friends, suppose if I want to go for birthday certificate, naturally I can open the portal of corresponding organization, get various performa regarding birthday certificate, handed over to those after completion of various information required by that performa. So, for getting form, nowhere I need to move to that organization. Dissemination of information about various schemes launched by department or organization. Friends, in this current era, naturally we are having a very competitive age. So, organization or department are in a position to quickly launch the information. So, these information even can be launched by them using internet, and as far as dissemination is concerned, it is tremendous fast and having very good performance. Video conferencing in various offices. Now, friends, when suppose any chief minister or prime minister wants to have a meeting of various departments which are geographically at distinct location. So, nowadays there is no any necessity to call them physically at one place. Instead, with the help of video conferencing, we even can have a meeting, and this meeting even will be going to result as if it were a physical meeting. Transmission of message using email services of internet. Most of the organization, most of the government department nowadays are using email. So, email is one of the very best way as far as fast communication is concerned and proper delivery of information is concerned. monitoring using e-portal by various government other offices. Friends, a particular officer which is at the topmost level, if wants to monitor what our underlying officers are doing, so naturally with the help of portal, by acquiring various information, that particular officer even can watch, monitor whether the things are even at par or not. If there are certain flaws, then it even can be handled in between. Now, when I want to say something about various governance facility which are used by student segment, then students generally are going to appear for examinations. So, various examination activities nowadays are supposed to be provided with the help of internet. So, conduction of various examination related online activities. Friends, when I want to say online examinations, so there are two segments. One, by simply calling students at a single center with the help of internet, they even can appear for exam. Means nowhere this sort of facility will be provided to students at his home or at the location decided by the candidate. When I want to say online examination in some another segment, that means we even can launch certain queries over the internet, we even can start the examination. Student from any location can appear for the examination, and after successful completion, the examination will be over. Various brochures, information on the e-portal, all organization who are involved in examination activities putting their brochures information on the e-portal, so that as far as physically distribution is concerned, they are getting rid of it. Form filling is one of the very tremendous facility provided by examination conducting authorities. So, students simply by sitting at his home, making payment by credit card or debit card, can fill the form. Admit card distribution, as far as earlier issues are concerned, we were supposed to transmit the admission card to students physically. Nowadays, there is no necessity of transmitting the admission card physically. There might be postal delay, there might be some other issues. So, students can download their admission card with the help of e-portal. Collection of marks using e-portal, this is another facility used by various universities or institution. They are going to say their corresponding colleges to enter marks in the portal provided by university. Universities can fill information whatever required by their own in a specific format. Respective institution will be going to see that particular format and provides the corresponding information. So, without having any large volume of person involved, the university will be getting proper marks. Result publishing, everywhere result is being published using internet only. Counseling for various admission process. Nowadays, friends, there is no any necessity to move to a specific location where admission is supposed to be handled. Instead, whatever information required by the admission authority are provided over the internet. Students or participants simply go through those information, and after going through all the information successfully, they even can provide the information required, and after some processing work by the admission authority, the corresponding allotment regarding college, branch, etc. will be provided to the students. So, this also helps the students sitting at home going to see where they have been admitted. Friends, today I have discussed some issues as far as IP address is concerned. Though I am sure that none of we people are using IP address directly. In some special case we are using it, but as you have seen, the header of IP address contains tremendous facility, so that we even can judge what it is transmitting. Ideally, friends, I have discussed various applications, various activities which are conducted by internet, which helps us as far as our quick dissemination of information is concerned, proper response is concerned regarding business, educations, and various governance facilities.